The planet is in crisis.
If we don't act urgently, it'll be too late.
Right now, the world is not on track to reach net zero by 2050.
For the first time in human history, there is no choice between the economy and the ecology.
Change is needed, and the solutions are already in our hands.
It is a global problem, and we have to solve it together.
The race is on. I'm Bertrand Piccard, an explorer and clean technology pioneer. I've teamed up with science journalist Sam Pauly, and we're traveling over 1,000 kilometers across Switzerland using only zero fossil fuels vehicles, discovering hydropower's role in building the carbon neutral future upon which we depend.
Bertrand, here we are at the start of our Swiss road trip adventure. I am so excited.
We're going to see people who are producing clean, local, decarbonized energy. And how do they produce it? With hydropower.
It sounds great. Why are we still standing here?
Let's go.
Let's do it. Our journey starts high in the Swiss Alps at an altitude of nearly 2,000 meters. Here we are, Bertrand, at Nant de Drance, and it is incredible. But apart from the beautiful view, what's so special about it?
Because it's a normal dam, plus the newest pumping storage installation in Switzerland over there. Now I'm going to explore the cavern with the turbines.
Have fun.
We are in a fantastic, magical cavern. Six turbines, it's like a gigantic battery.
Oui, c'est juste. Nant de Drance, c'est tout simplement une batterie qui fonctionne avec de l'eau. Nous allons pomper l'eau de la retenue inférieure, convertir l'énergie électrique en énergie hydraulique, et nous allons restituer l'énergie sur le réseau simplement en turbinant.
Because Nant de Drance acts as a gigantic battery, energy can be stored for when it's needed in order to stabilize the grid.
It's a battery the size of a nuclear power station. We can charge this battery at a rate of 600 Teslas a minute, and it's completely renewable and completely CO2 free. What we're all looking for is stable, renewable energy. You know, it's solar, you can put wind in there as well, but you do need that storage aspect to it, because if the sun doesn't shine and the wind doesn't blow, obviously we don't produce power anymore. So you have to have the aspect of storage there, which this pump storage does provide. It's an incredibly powerful means to installing more renewable energy.
Nant de Drance has a lifespan of around 80 years. So it is really fantastic to just be able to come here and see this truly sustainable hydropower plant. From the start of the project, Nant de Drance worked with environmental organisations to offset the construction's environmental impact, with an emphasis on recreating habitats for endangered animal and plant species in Switzerland.
What is a sustainable dam and what is an unsustainable dam?
Over the last 15 years, we've been working with WWF, IUCN, the Nature Conservancy, the government of Norway, a large, broad spectrum of stakeholders to define exactly what that means. Last year, we launched the Hydropower Sustainability Standard, which means that now any one of these projects can be certified, third-party certification, and say, this is a sustainable project or this is not. And that really is something that industry needs to pick up. We need to demonstrate that hydropower can be done sustainably.
That's a great step forward.
Absolutely, absolutely. But it requires now industry to pick up the baton and run with it.
Next stop, Bern, and the chance to reflect on our trip to Nant de Drance. So, Bertrand, can you tell me about the cavern? What did you find out there?
It's impressive because it's a long tunnel.
Yeah.
You have a huge cavern, but you have six turbines, and the turbine is the pump, and the pump is the turbine. So you just reverse the direction, and you get the water up, or you produce the electricity by having the water going down.
It's really efficient, isn't it? It's such an efficient way of using that technology.
Yes, it's the technology allowing common sense to be used.
Whilst you were checking out the cavern, I was taking a walk around across the dam, and there were loads of people, you know, loads of hikers as well.
It's completely integrated into the landscape.
It doesn't damage anything. They destroy no wildlife. They destroy no forest because it's above the limit of the trees. It's really a fantastic way to produce energy.
Hydropower is not without its critics. And so we've stopped off in the Swiss capital of Bern so I can catch up with Ignacio Cassis to discuss some of the challenges.
We have to find a balanced way in order to combine the power supply and the protection of the nature. This political debate didn't take place in the last years because we had enough power supply. The war in Ukraine and the increased price of electricity and of energy production is a very powerful trigger for this political discussion. Because if you are in your comfort zone, you know that the power supply is given, but if suddenly you are threatened to be in a warm room in the winter, to have your electronic needs covered, then you are more open to discuss about these dilemmas.
It's been well worth stopping off in Bern and hearing that these dilemmas are being discussed and solutions found. But there is so much more to investigate on a Swiss tour. Next time, we will be visiting a truly innovative agricultural business, Switzerland's first carbon neutral plus sustainable farm. And we'll be learning about the reliability of hydropower and stop off at a plant being given a new lease of life so it can provide constant energy for many generations to come. Plus, we hear about new ways of thinking from global thought leaders.